In the animal management, we apply our theory classes to practical situations in the ADC and in the industry of our field trips. I enjoy the range of animals that we work with, as it gives me an insight of what I'm going to be able to do at the end of level 3.
What I've enjoyed most about working in BCOT is the different animals that we get to use in the ADC. Doing all sorts of different health checks helps with all sorts of assignments, from health, nutrition, accommodation and environment. It's all just very useful and it's something completely different.
It's important to health check and monitor our animals on a regular basis because, unlike humans, they're unable to tell us when they have an ear infection or an upset stomach of any sort. So generally, behaviour-wise, you commonly have a look at them each day and see how they're doing, but you've also got more thorough behaviour watching or observing, where you'd write down notes. That's normally when you more suspect something's up with them, or you may put something new in with their enclosure. It's just to see how they're reacting with that. Also, if they're having some sort of medication, it's good to do note-taking behaviour on that. And then you have health checks that also need to be done on a regular basis.
Like a star in my vast sleep, I opened my eyes to take a peek, to find that I was by the sea, gazing with tranquility. Just then when the hurdy-gurdy man came singing songs of love, then when the hurdy-gurdy man came singing songs of love.
Observing the behaviour of the rats tells you what enrichment they need. As you can see in this enclosure, we have a lot of enrichment that they can use to express their natural behaviours and how they would in the wild, including the ladders, including their houses that they can burrow in, and including a lot of panels and stuff like this. This allows them to express themselves in the entire enclosure and use the entire of the enclosure to their advantage. And by observing the behaviour, we can tell if they're stressed, if they're comfortable, if they're happy in the environment, and if it's suitable for them, and how they act as an animal.
During the spring, 16 million lambs will be born. So we've been doing lambing here at Sheep Drove Farm. So the teats on the ewe will swell and get bigger, and the vulva will go red. She will isolate herself from the flock. Hopefully during the course of the night her waters will break, and then she should hopefully have an unassisted birth. And within minutes the lambs should suckle. And then as soon as possible the tails will be donned. They'll have their ears tagged and they'll have iodine rubbed on their umbilical cords to stop infections and bacteria.
I'm Nicole Breslin.
I'm Brogan Russell, and we're here at Sheep Drove Farm. There are about 2,500 acres of land here, and they have loads of different animals, farm animals predominantly, like sheep, cows here, and we're here at the Shorthorn Cow Maternity Unit.
This unit shows various phases of a cow's life. So in here we have the cows that are currently settling, and then so that's the newborns. And then over here we have the calves that will go out within a week or so, depending on the weather.
Okay, so while at the Hawk Conservancy, we will undertake activities such as training displays. We will also carry out preventative care such as beak trimming and weighing, and this helps us with our exotics assignment and our ecology assignment.
At Chessington Zoo, we take on many practical tasks to help us with our zoology unit, as well as the behavioural side of things. So that would take a lot of graft work in terms of cleaning out gorilla enclosures, or for example feeding the giraffes as well, which goes onto the nutrition side of things. Today we're at Whipsnade Zoo at the Oriental Small Clawed Otter Enclosure. As you can see, there's a section for the mainland area and the moat, which protects the otters and the public from each other. According to the DEFRA inspection report, this meets the five freedoms. Also, otters are naturally well equipped for swimming in the water with their agile and streamlined bodies. However, this isn't a naturally keen behaviour, so they need to learn this from when they're infants, and they'll gain confidence from their parents. In captivity, if for some reason they're not with their biological parents, it would be important for zookeepers to encourage this behaviour, as otherwise they wouldn't be able to be released into the wild, because swimming is enables them to thrive in terms of foraging for food such as crustacean items within weeds and other vegetation.
Food companionship, purpose, protection, as well as service dogs. So for the police, the army, the guide dogs for the blind, working dogs, as well as dogs which help with illnesses such as detecting seizures and epileptic fits. It also promotes responsibility for children, as well as bonding between people. It also provides employment such as breeding, dog walking and boarding, as well as for the nutritional industries and grooming industries.
Negatives include interbreeding, so health issues related to pedigree dogs, pugs, labradors, so hip dysplasia, breathing issues. They should be socialised, they're pack animals, this can lead to stress, dangerous to the public and other dogs. Puppy farms, where the welfare needs aren't met. Bred for fighting, used as weapons, dangerous dogs act. Spread of disease, so dog poo, and provides employment, so rescue, welfare charities, veterinary sector, RSPCA and Dogs Trust.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Here's a little number I tossed off recently in the Caribbean. Isn't it awfully nice to have a penis? Isn't it frightfully good to have a dong? It's swell to have a stiffy, it's divine to own a dick. From the tiniest little tadger to the world's biggest prick. So three cheers for your Willie or John Thomas. Hooray for your one-eyed trouser snake. Your piece of pork, your wife's best friend, your Percy or your cock. You can wrap it up in ribbons, you can slip it in your sock. But don't take it out in public or they will stick you in the dock. And you won't a come a back. Oh, thank you very much.
A strange glow in the sky, and nobody seems to know where you go, and what does it mean? Oh, is it a dream? Bright eyes, burning like fire.
Over 20 years to get the message across about plastic pollution. The mentality that, semicolon, if it doesn't directly impact me in my daily life, why should I care? Also known as no skin off my nose. Ignorance of the sheer scale of the damage to sea life that occurs from complacent and irresponsible means of disposal. In the past, there had been very little media coverage about the ocean, and sewage was routinely pumped into the sea. Plastic was seen as an efficient, easy to produce, safe and cost-effective way of storage. No one knew that it would take such a considerable length of time to break down naturally. So remember to just reduce, reuse, recycle.
Reuse, recycle. Reduce, reuse, recycle.
In the summer, the animal management students have an opportunity to go to South Africa for a trip. We will be doing conservation works, learning about the wildlife in there and the anti-poaching projects they have over there. We will also be doing key life skills like camping out in the fields and hunting and tracking the animals themselves.
Independently, I will be going to Greece with our organization called Archeon. They help with turtle conservation in the Mediterranean area, and they also help with like preserving turtle nests and also help rehabilitate injured turtles from the ongoing plastic situation in the ocean and also like propeller damage from boats.
Working with animals is all about poo. Everyone has told us that, from the guest speakers to the people at our work placements. We clean and muck out animals from insects to rhinos. Big, small, runny, pellets, scats and splats, essential to prevent disease. We inspect poo for health, for its consistency, the animal's diet, parasites and water intake. Also, if you like to track wildlife, you guessed it, you track their poo.
And I already work at Four Kingdoms as an animal keeper, a job I obtained through college practical days and work experience.
I'd like to be an RSPCA inspector. I know I need good people skills and I now know what to expect as we have studied animal welfare issues.
I'm going to pursue a zoo career. Through college experiences, I have worked and studied in zoos. and I now know what to expect.
I undertake my work at companion care vets, and this has given me valuable experience observing operations and learning from vet nurses. Now I know what to expect.
Ooga chaka, ooga, ooga, ooga chaka, ooga, ooga, ooga chaka, ooga, ooga, ooga chaka, ooga, ooga.
I can't stop this feeling deep inside of me. Girl, you just don't realize what you do to me. When you hold me in your arms so tight, you let me know everything's alright. I'm hooked on a feeling. I'm high on believing.
Thank you for watching.
Yeah, we're going wrong. We've all become the same. We dress the same.